Once upon a time, there was a lovely princess. But she had an enchantment upon her of a fearful sort, which could only be broken by love's first kiss. She was locked away in a castle, guarded by a terrible fire-breathing dragon. Many brave knights had attempted to free her from this dreadful prison, but none prevailed. She waited in the dragon's keep, in the highest room of the tallest tower, for her true love and true love's first kiss. Like that's ever gonna happen. What a logic.
So funny once told me the world is on a rolling, I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with a finger and a thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and don't stop coming. Get to the rules and hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart, but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see, so much longer it takes you to life's feet. You'll never know when you don't go. You'll never try if you don't go.
Kind of thing going on, and I like it. Whoa! Who lives in a house like that?
That would be my home.
Woo! Can I say something? You are quite the decorator. It's amazing what you've done with such a modest budget. Oh, I like that boulder. That is a nice boulder. I guess you don't entertain much.
No, I like my privacy.
That's another thing we got in common. Can I stay with you?
What?
Please, let me stay with you. No, I don't want to go back there. You don't know what it's like. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Or maybe you do. Can I stay with you?
Okay, but one night only.
Yeah, woo!
That's my seat.
Wow, this is going to be so fun. We can stay up late all night, swapping merry stories. And in the morning, I'm making waffles. You want me to go outside?
Outside! Now!
Oh, I guess outside is fine. I like the outdoors. Good night. I'm a donkey. I was born outside. I love the outdoors. I guess I'll go out here all by myself, all alone. No one here.
Gosh,
no one invited us.
What?
We were forced to come here.
By who?
Lord Farquhar. He huffed and he puffed and he signed an eviction notice.
Does anyone know where this Farquhar guy is?
I know where he is. I know.
Does anyone else know where to find him? Anyone?
Me.
Anyone?
Me. I know where he is.
All right. Attention all green-tailed creatures, do not get comfortable. Your welcome is officially worn out. I'm going to see this Farquhar guy right now and get you all off my land and back where you came from.
Yeah!
Oh, you're coming with me.
All right, lucky! Oh, man, second donkey to stalwart friends. Off to the whirlwind mid-city adventure. I like it. On the road again.
Of them all.
Well, technically you're not king.
And what do you mean by that?
Well, what I mean is, you're not king yet. But you can become one. All you have to do is marry a princess.
Go on.
So would you sit back and relax a lot? Because it's time for you to meet today's eligible bachelorettes. And here they are.
Bachelorette number one is a mental case shut in from the kingdom of Goldflower. She likes steak and hot tubbing any time. Her hobbies include cooking and cleaning for her evil older sister, Edie. Give it up for Princess Erica!
And back to number two, is the Cape Queen of Yarn from the land of the Muppets.
Although she lives with seven other men, she's not easy. Just kiss her dead frozen lips and find out what a live wife she is. Give it up for Princess Jenny!
Bachelorette number three is a fine redhead
from a dragon garden castle surrounded by bot hot and lava. But don't let that cool you off. She's a loaded pistol who likes pina coladas and getting caught in the rain. Here's to the rescue, Princess Fiona.
So, what's it going to be, my lord? One, two, or three?
What do you think? I'm going for three. She was rick tidy.
Lord Farquhar, you have chosen Princess Fiona.
Ah, Princess Fiona, she will be my queen.
But I promise you mention the little thing.
Silence! I'll do it.
Yes, but I...
Enough! Guards, round up some men. We're going to have a tournament.
So that must be Lord Farquhar's castle.
Yeah, that's the place.
It's quiet. Too quiet.
Yeah, it's a little quiet. Hey, look at these.
Some of you may die, but it's a sacrifice I'm willing to make. Ha! Ah, it's hideous!
Oh, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Indeed. Knight, new plan. Whoever kills the ogre shall become the champion. Have at him!
Oh, that's not fair. Can't we just sell this over a pint? No? Come on then.
No, mind him. Ah! You've earned the right to be champion. And to embark on a great and noble quest.
I'm already in a quest. A quest to get my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Aye, my swamp. May Dunkle's fear to your sins.
Indeed, knight. Indeed, ogre. We can make a deal. If you go on this quest with me, I'll give you your swamp back.
Exactly the way it was.
Down to the last slime-covered toadstool.
And the swatters.
As good as gold.
What kind of quest?
Wait, we're going to go and rescue our princess from a dragon-guarded castle just so this Farquhar guy will give you a swamp back, which you don't have because he took it from you by filling it full of fairy tale creatures.
You know, maybe that's a good reason Zucky shouldn't talk.
Keep going, Fred. Oh, we definitely have a bunch.
Believe me, donkey, if it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone. We must be getting close.
Don't go talking about leggings, the brimstone. I know that bill, and I didn't spill no brimstone. And it didn't come off no stone, neither.
That'll do, donkey. That'll do.
Here, where is this fire-breathing painting and egg here?
Inside, waiting for Stracia.
I was talking about the dragon trap. Hey, are you scared?
No.
But...
Donkey, okay, two things. Shut up! Right, I'll go find the princess, you go find if there's any stairs.
Stairs? What do you mean by stairs for?
Well, the princess will be the highest room in the tallest tower.
Alright, how do you know that?
I'll come in a bit once.
Alright, you handle the dragon, I'll handle the stairs. I'll find those stairs. I'll whip their butt too. I'll step all over their heads.
Well, at least you know where the princess is, but where's the...
Dynamite! I don't need no dynamite! I'll kill with my bare hands! Oh, this guy is incorrigible!
Are you Princess Fiona?
I am. Await the knights of Baldrick.
We've no time, come on.
But wait, this is our first meeting. Shouldn't it be a wonderful romantic moment?
No.
But you should sweep me off my feet at yonder window and down a rope onto your valley instead.
You've been a long time to plan this, haven't you?
But we should savour this moment. Can I at least know the name of my champion?
Shrek.
Sir Shrek, I pray that you take this favour as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks.
Ha, princess!
What?
Hi, forget the shortest trick.
You did it, you rescued me. You're wonderful, you're amazing. You're a little unorthodox, I'll admit, but thy deed is great and thy heart is pure, and I'm eternally in your debt. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
You hear that? She called me a steed! She thinks I'm a steed!
The battle is won. You may remove your helmet now, good Sir Shrek. Why not?
I've got a helmet here.
Please, I wouldn't sit upon the face of my rescuer.
No, you wouldn't.
But how will you kiss me?
What? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
Oh, it's destiny. You must know how it goes. A princess locked in a tower and beset by a dragon is rescued by a brave knight, and they share true love's first kiss.
Wait a minute. You think Shrek is your true love?
Well, yes.
Let's just say I'm out of time, okay?
But you're my rescuer, so remove your helmet.
No!
Take the helmet off.
I'm not taking it off!
Take it off!
No!
Now!
Alright, okay. As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre?
Oh, you were expecting Prince Charming, were you?
Well, yes, not an ogre.
Right, I was sent here by Lord Farquaad.
Well, why didn't he come and rescue me?
Good question. You should ask him that when we get there.
Well, I'll be waiting right here until Lord Farquaad comes to get me.
Hey, I'm no one's master boy. I'm a delivery boy.
Hit me, Dad!
I'm not behind you!
This big whip, would you? I'm done too. Me too.
Well, people say, they say people that come out and show up supply.
Oh, stop it, stop
and some
it.
People think little of him.
Oh, stop it, stop it, you two. Yous are just jealous you can't measure up to be a great ruler like Lord Farquhar.
Measure, ruler. It's getting late.
Shouldn't we stop to make camp?
Good idea.
Hey, do you want me to read you a bedtime story?
No, good night.
Oh, right. Hey, I'm gonna sleep right there.
Makes me wanna turn around and fix me one.
You don't threaten me, Dick. Lord Farquaad compensate for something. But I think he's got a really, really small owl.
What Doug is trying to say is, it doesn't matter, right?
Are you all right?
Perfect. Never been better.
You
don't need to tell me anything, Princess. Why would anyone love an ugly beast like me?
I don't think you thought I love.
Well, I do. Valentine, now hand it over.
Princess Fiona. Very well, Ogre. The deed to your swamp.
Lord Farquaad, I was just saying a quick farewell to Shrek.
Oh, you don't have to waste good manners on the ogre. Not like they have feelings. Aww. Princess Fiona, will you be the perfect bride to the perfect groom?
I am set.
Excellent! Guards, round up some guests. Get a cake book. And all the wedding stuff.
Oh, okay.
You can't marry him.
And why not?
Preposterous. It's really not good enough being alive, let alone brain ruining my wedding.
He's only marrying you to be king.
Outrageous.
He's not your true love.
And what do you know about true love?
All I know is that I love you.
Aww. Fiona, we're about a kiss away from our happy ever after. Now kiss me. And for you, my wife, I'll have you locked back in that tower from whence you came. I will have order, I will have peace, I will have perfection, I will have nobody move, I'm a donkey on the ears.
Gemma, Sloan and Erin Brown. Woo! And off the top, so Graham and John Kaiser. Just get the curtain going tonight, hopefully. Pull the curtain to the right, Kaiser! And also a few more people, Alan Ramsey, who made the scenery for us tonight, and Emily Nash, who've done a wonderful job of painting, as I'm sure you'll agree. Thanks to my secretary, Sarah, is literally does everything in the background, keeps everything I'm not good at, she's been perfect. So thank you to her. And the past couple of years now we've introduced the Alvin Watson Award. Now this award goes to our best member within the club during concert. And you'll have seen a lot of him through tonight. He's about 10 feet tall and a bit wide. Right, so, come on. Right, the
thanks very much for this. I wasn't expecting it. This is my last year doing the concert because I'm nearly as old as Andy Hannah.
At least you can when you outfits
it. Aye, I'm good. Okay. No, I'm old then. So, right, well, thanks very much and thanks you for coming along tonight.
Thanks everybody for coming. We couldn't do this without you.
Hold on before Col says what he's got to say. It's been good at thanking everybody else, and I think you'll all agree, him and Sarah have done a tremendous job this year at the concert. So a massive round of applause and well done for all of them.
We wouldn't do these concerts if it wasn't so well supported by everyone here tonight, so thank you very much and have a safe journey home.